With a referendum due later this year, I believe the time for the voice has come. I believe in local and regional voices. I believe in a national voice drawn from local and regional bodies, and I will support the referendum being put this year. I believe that the voice can help move the dial on Indigenous education, health, housing, safety and economic development. A short time ago, I resigned as Shadow Attorney General and Shadow Minister for Indigenous Australians. I've had many respectful discussions with colleagues about the voice over the past year. I've listened to their views and they've heard mine, but ultimately I haven't been able to persuade them. It's clear that the Shadow Cabinet and the party room and I have taken a different position in relation to the voice. Peter and I had a conversation about my position last December on the voice, and we've talked several times since. They've been respectful conversations. Peter did everything he could to keep me. I respect that and I respect him very much. But it was clear on the day before Shadow Cabinet and the party room meeting last week that I was in a different position to a majority of my colleagues. At that point, Peter and I agreed that I would take the Passover and Easter break to reflect on my position, which I've done. My resignation about today as a frontbencher is not about personality. It's about trying to keep faith with the very cords of belief and belonging that are part of who I am. Keeping faith with the first peoples of this land who want to have a stake in their own future, with a structural change in our constitution to help improve the quality of their lives. Keeping faith with the constitution, that invisible pillar that holds our nation together. Keeping faith with my parliamentary colleagues, men and women who believe in this country and work tirelessly for it every day. And keeping faith with my family and my community, who keep sending me to Parliament as their representative. But above all, keeping faith with my values. Liberal values based on a fair-minded conservative temperament that caused me to get involved in this issue more than a decade ago. As a Liberal, I believe in the dignity of every Australian, in what can be achieved when they are affirmed, valued and empowered. I believe better policy is made when the very people who are affected by it are consulted. I believe that through empowering people and by building institutions that shift responsibility and decision-making closer to people, we're more likely to shift the dial on Indigenous health, education, housing, safety and economic advancement. As a Conservative, I believe in our shared national fabric. We need to find common ground as Australians, not just on this issue, but on so many more. No great nation has ever been built by dividing it. Good nations engage in the search for common purpose and common ground. I believe that the government must seriously engage with coalition voters, and it hasn't done so to date. And this failure could ultimately put the referendum at risk. When it comes to the voice, I believe that Australians who remain to be convinced by the yes case fall into three groups. The first group are those opposed to the voice on philosophical or constitutional grounds. The second group are those who support the voice in principle or who want to support it, but who in the vast majority of cases have genuine doubts and questions about the proposal that the government's put forward. And the third group are yet to engage, but they too will have questions and concerns. I understand those concerns. I too have wrestled with them. I believe that during the committee and parliamentary debates in the months ahead, we can answer those concerns and put the referendum on a surer footing for success.